Everyone will know that it's real. What you make me feel. Until there's no more of me, I will try to make you see that I will give my all. And watch him grow. Cross my heart and I hope to die. If I ever make you
Yes.
God in creation made two from one. Today, by marriage, he makes one from two. Your marriage celebrated here today and forged out by the years that lie ahead are going to lead to tremendous times of discovery and growth for you. On behalf of your families and on behalf of your friends, I'm going to thank both of you for inviting us here to witness your wedding vows. And I ask all who are here to respect this marriage by offering to Andy and to Jennifer your friendship and support. Who gives this woman to be married to this man? To your eyes, just a touch of love and a touch of grace to softly fall on your moonlit face. And with this day our lives will start, let nothing keep our love apart. I'll take your hand to hold in mine and be together through all time. You know, being your intention to give yourselves one to the other, Jennifer, why don't you pass your flowers over to your maid of honor? Face one another for your vows and join hands. Just relax and let's enjoy the journey. We'll start with you, Andy. Before God and these witnesses, will you take Jennifer to be your wife? Will you stay with her no matter what happens between you? When you have difficult times, as will happen, will you work to bring the two of you back together again? When both of you experience unfulfilled needs, will you persistently try to understand Jennifer? To restore your relationship. And when all is wonderful and you are happy, will you rejoice over your life together and continue to keep your relationship growing and strong for as long as you both shall live? If so, answer, I do.
I do.
And before God and these witnesses, Jennifer, will you take Andy to be your husband? Will you work at loving Andy every day, unselfishly and unconditionally, showing him respect even at the times you think he is wrong? Will you promise to remain faithful to him and be his most intimate friend? Will you work at cherishing Andy for who he is? And Jennifer says, save me. He's doing it too. Bless your heart, Andy. You're doing a good job. Will you seek to understand Andy and his needs and give him first place in your life, Jennifer? Will you, forsaking all others, work together with Andy to preserve this marriage bond for as long as you both shall live? If so, answer, I do. And Andy, would you repeat after me, okay?
I, Andy, take thee, Jennifer, to be my wife. Better or worse, or richer or poorer, I'll seek the soul's health, love and cherish.
Jennifer, would you repeat after me? Okay. Hey, Jennifer, take me, Andy, to be my husband. Likewise, Andy, this rings a reminder of Jennifer's great desire to be your wife. Wear this ring with confidence that your love for each other will continue for life. You know, we read in the Bible that God made a promise with Noah. He placed a rainbow in the sky, and every time we see a rainbow, we're reminded that God is keeping his promise to Noah never to flood the earth again. I think it's fitting you've chosen rings to be the reminder of your promises made here today. Those rings are made of a precious metal, surely very symbolic of the value of your relationship. Those rings cannot be broken unless by some outside force. Let your love for each other continue through life and through time until broken by death alone. In fact, every time you find yourself looking at your rings and admiring them and touching them, let that be the reminder to you to keep the vows you so confidently have made here today. Andy and Jennifer, can you believe it's your wedding day? Beautiful day. The guys in their immaculate tuxedos and the gals in their beautiful dresses. Weddings are wonderful. Really, it's the start of a marriage. Our main goal is actually to launch a marriage today. A wedding lasts for a day, but a marriage is designed to last for a lifetime. Now, this is the last advice the two of you will hear before you're married. You know, I'm going to coach you just briefly on how to build a marriage. You know, marriage has fallen on hard times. Check the stats. 50% of those who have a wedding day that they're having one day call it quits. That's why, because building a good marriage is the hardest work anyone will ever do. It's hard work because marriage is the collision of two histories. I smile when I think of a little girl playing wedding with two dolls at her grandmother's. She's playing like the doll was changing their vows. Here's what the grandmother heard. You have the right to remain silent. Anything you say can and will be used against you in a court of law. You have the right to an attorney present. You know, Andy and Jennifer, remaining silent or having an attorney present is not the way to build your marriage. You see, the success in marriage comes not in finding the right person who will always make you happy as the fairy tale goes, but rather the ability of both partners to adjust to the person they discover they are married. I'd like to just leave with you several never forgets. In the years of marital counseling, the 30 years I've been performing weddings, I've created just a very short list of never forgets that can help you build a really wonderful. First is this: never forget you're a gift to each other. When you get a gift, as you get many gifts for your wedding, as you open each gift, you're going to always act like you like it, even if you don't. Remember that on some of the tough days when it doesn't feel quite like the same as today. The person you're looking at and holding is a gift to you. Treasure them like a gift. Secondly, never stop working on yourself. It's more important that you work on yourself than that you work on your spouse. Being the right person is more important than marrying the right person. Every time you work on yourself, your spouse is going to look better. The third is the toughest of all, but I can promise you it will save you from a broken relationship. More divorce could be settled and never happen if they kept this one. Here's a thought. Never forget the need to always be right to prove your spouse wrong. It will lead to a strained relationship. Here's the tough part. Learn to let your spouse be right most of the time, even when you think they're wrong. Tough, but it can work. Here's the fourth, just two more. Never forget the tongue can make or break your relationship. It is the smallest member in both of your bodies. But all by itself, it can lead to, with unkind words, profound wounds that may never heal in a lifetime. And here's the final. Never forget, every marriage starts out good. I mean, this is an absolutely wonderful, beautiful day for you. Every good marriage will eventually bump into something difficult. Begin now to put the tools in place that you'll need to help you with the difficult. Andy and Jennifer, may God bless you both in this pursuit to build a strong and lasting marriage. May your relationship demonstrate to all of your family, to all of your friends, that marriage can really work. Remember, God is the third partner in your marriage. I love the little verse in Ecclesiastes 4:12, which says, a home of one can easily be overpowered. Two can defend themselves better. But a cord of three strands is not easily broken. May you always give God a place. place in your lives and in your home as you build your marriage, creating a cord of three strands.
I played for the important stuff. Can everyone please take their seats and direct their attention towards the door?
You guys get fed first.
Coming in first, we have Tracy Schreger and RJ Plain. Jillian Beckley and Rob Lewis. Colleen Nolte and Rob Kershaw. Heather Murphy and Jesse Kershaw.
Awesome show!
Roxanne Spencer and George Joseph. Christy Farah and Richie Andish. Lisa Vaughn. Ariel Bowen and Dan Farrah. And now, Mr. and Mrs. Andrew Farrah.
Ladies and gentlemen, bride, groom, may I first say that the bridesmaids are looking absolutely stunning. But second to none to our lovely bride, Jen. For those of you who don't know me, my name is Daniel Farrah. I'm brother to the now infamous Andy Baby. It's been 32 years since Grandma Sam, Mom, decided not to give him up because he was so brown and cute. Can you believe that he still walks around telling people that he's part brown sugar? Since then, we've had many epic adventures together, from running to and from school, running from the police, and the many vacations I talked him into. So the time that we spent together means that, in a way, Andy's shaped my sense of humor. So at any time you think this speech is not funny, you can blame it on him. So Drupal, my wingman, my partner in crime, my best friend, where do I begin? How about the evenings at Robbie Lou's with Andy chasing women around the pool table with his tongue hanging out in a drunken stupor? He finally found the woman of his dreams, and I thought someday was Sunday. Who would have ever thought it was Friday? They'll get that one. If anybody was wondering, I'm digging the way. He'll get that one too. Alright, so if for everybody that was in the pool and had the lucky number 28, there's a free drink at the bar for you. Andy, we know what your number is.
86.
If you have Arnie, you actually owe me one, because I told you you wouldn't run. And we had many memorable experiences together. Even now, we share over a shot of tequila and a beer. The days in the Detroit house, making that big score of half-smoked cigarettes from Richie's house. Thanks, Joan. The trip to Tennessee, Florida, and Mark Park. Too many times have we cheated death, and thank God, because now I have the honor of sharing the top table with you and your beautiful bride standing as your best man. Thank you. It is truly an honor. Last week, I asked Andy what he wanted most from marriage. He said, a long-lasting love, 6 boys, 4 girls, and of course, Jenny. Later that day, I asked Jenny that same question, and she replied, a stove and a dishwasher. See, man, some women are easy to please. But I have my orders from Jenny and Andy, not to mention the bachelor party, the traffic light last night, or the other things, you know. I have no other alternative than to find some other story, embarrassing, you know, to share with you all. So here it goes. For those of you who don't know her, when you first meet her, Jenny is very quiet and soft-spoken. She lets her beauty speak for her. You then learn her last name and realize that if you're nice enough, you'll probably get a good deal on a food processor or something Cuisinart has to offer. Then she warms up and watch out, buddy, because the party is on. I had no clue on how that would come to be better than one night they came home after a night of serious partying. And Andy says, Jenny's going to stay the night over. We were living on Claire House, and she's going to stay the night over because she's pretty wrecked and I don't want her to drive. I said, that's fine, Andy. You know, we'll get her some, you know, a sheet and a blanket and whatnot. So we were walking back into the kitchen, and Jenny had already done so. She went to sleep on my kitchen counter. Right, Arnie. And if you don't believe me, I have the pictures right here. All right, finally, there are a couple of thank yous that I've been asked to say. First, the seating arrangers, there was a method to the madness for the way you were seated, and that would be the gift list. So Steve and Robin, mentioning no names, thanks for the candles. Secondly, there are two people that worked very hard making this night possible, and Natalie, let's give a round of applause for them, everybody. Thank you, bartender. But seriously, on a serious note, I want to send a huge thank you out to the moms, Karen, Sam, and everybody, the girls, spelled with two R's, for putting this beautiful day together and making it so magical. All right, could everybody grab their glass, please? All right. I believe I can speak for everybody here in wishing Andy and Jenny congratulations and welcome to the rest of your life.
If you don't know, my name is Arielle, and I'm the friend and
maid of honor to the bride. Beautiful bride, that is. Once I read that a person would be truly lucky to find one great friend in his or her entire life. I guess Jen lucked out with me, right? Along the behalf of the bridesmaid and myself, I just want to say how absolutely radiant you look today. It has truly been a blessed day for all of us. You know, Jen and I have been friends for quite some time now, and over the years, she has taught me a very valuable lesson. She's taught me that friendship is the most important next to family. Jen is just as loving as she is supportive, and that's why she's my friend. I have so many wonderful memories of us together, as I'm sure we all have, and we'll cherish them forever. The fondest memory I will now have is witnessing her marry her best friend and life companion today, on November 28th.
September.
September 28th. Just making sure you're listening. I actually today we celebrate everything they have found in one another. A best friend, a teacher, and a true partner for life. I love you both very much. You are two very dear friends to me. In the past year, I have seen you both grow as individuals and flourish as a couple. Separately, you are both very special, remarkable people. But together, you're complete. I would like you to all please raise your glasses in a toast to Jen and Andy. May your love be like the wind, strong enough to move the clouds, soft enough to never hurt, but always and never ending. Congratulations.
Cheers.
Two or more of you are gathered together in my name, I am there also. Believing you are present here with us today, we ask you for a special blessing for Andrew and Jennifer Farah. Today, Andrew and Jennifer Farah have vowed to love, honor, and respect one another all of their lives. We ask you, Heavenly Father, to bestow on them the grace needed to keep these promises. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Now let us join together and say grace together. Bless us, O Lord, and these thy gifts, which we are about to receive from thy bounty, through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Okay, and here on dinner. Thank you, everyone. Dancing together for the first time as husband and wife.
Andy and Jennifer Farah. The bouquets actually say something different. If yours says you will marry someone you meet here tonight, you're the winner. Okay, can we get a chair out to the dance floor for Jennifer? Single man behind me over here. Anyone from the bridal party? There's a single man come on over
Hello, fine people. Star you see will be the one that